Hello guys, in this tutorial I'm gonna create this kind of material, a building material, you can see here. And what I got is, I got this textures I created in Photoshop. As you can see, I got this brightness controls and the color shift, which is pretty cool. And also got a normal mass strength control. So let's get started. First of all, I'm gonna create a new material. I'm gonna call it a building glass. And open this up. And I'm gonna import all of these textures into this window, and let's place it. So basically, I got this color map, which is I'm gonna connect to base color. Yeah, we got this color now. So now I got these two textures, and basically this is gonna be our roughness. You know, the black is 0 and white is 1. So 0 roughness means mirror reflection. So, and I have a 0 value of roughness on the window area, the glass area. So, and this one, which is inverted image of this roughness map, I'm gonna connect this to specular and metallic. If you want to know how to create this kind of material, check out my other tutorial video. So now we got this kind of cool glass panel. So after that, I also got this normal map. You can connect this into normal directly, but you can see we got this kind of weird surface going on. So what I want to do is control this normal map strength. To do so, disconnect it. I'm going to use this red and green channel as create a multiply node and copy this and connect the green channel into another multiply node, and I have a scalar parameter. This is going to be controlling our normal strength. So let's connect it into a B of this two. And now I'm going to do is append this two. Can create a append vector node and connect this two, and create another append node and connect this. And now I'm going to connect the blue channel into B, and now we got our normal control. So connect here, and now you can go back to our scalar parameter. You can control the number. I'm going to set it to 0.15. That's a bit better. I got this, and now next thing I want to do is a emissive map. So let's save it. Let me apply this material to check out what's happening. As you can see, this is not. If I want to repeat this texture to make a little more realistic looking, so let's go back to the materializer. I'm gonna pick this UV from the texture sample, and let's create a texture coordinate node. You can connect this into all of this texture samples like that. Because we got our emiss map down there. So now we can repeat texture. I'm gonna repeat it 15 times. Oh, let's check this out. I guess it's a little too much. I guess I got to set it to 10. So I want to set this to something like 5. That, yeah, I guess it's kind of nice. Let's check this out in the daytime. Let me just update the sky and reflection proof. Update your reflection captures. As you can see, it's kind of nice. You can look around. We got this nice mirror reflections. You can of course control the reflection captures to get proper reflections. But now, right now, I'm happy with that. Now let's go back to the night time. We got this night. Update the reflection captures again. Now all I'm gonna do is add some lights on the surface by using emissive map. I just created this emissive map. I found this building image on Google and just attach it this into the this color texture. That's kind of tricky thing. I just erased a little bit to make a random spawners there. Anyway, you can check out my other tutorial to create that those kind of textures. So anyway, I'm gonna pick the texture sample, and let's say I want to control the brightness of this, because if we connect it directly into the emissive color, you can see it's kind of dim. And check this out in the viewport. Yeah, it's kind of dim. If you want to just control the brightness of it, just pick this out, and of course you can multiply it. We can add another scalar parameter. This is gonna be controlling our brightness. And what I wanna do next is actually I want to change the color. If I wanna change the color of the lights, I can use the hue shifts node. And it creates just like that, but actually this thing has to be in this texture connection and connect it to texture, and let's copy this scalar parameter and let's connect this into the hue shift percentage results. And now we're pretty done, and now we can connect it to emissive color. Now basically it's done, but you can see any lights right now. We can control it later. So it's kind of messed up, so now I'm gonna organize it a little bit. Let me just select this thing and down, and you can press C key to group this up. Say emissive. And got scala parameter. The reason I'm using the scala parameter is if I use constant, I can control this values in real time when I create material instance out of this material. So that's the reason why I'm using scala parameter instead of using constant value. So let's set this to brightness. Brightness on this thing, I'm gonna call it color shift. On this thing, controls the normal strength. And that's all we have in this material. You also multiply these color maps to change the base color or control the reflections of this material. So let's group this normal map. Call this normal map. If you want, you can just name it. I'm gonna call it albedo. This thing is roughness. This thing is controlling the metallic and also specular. Can move this thing around and just clean this up. UV tiling, maybe like that. Now it's organized. You can save this out. Now I'm gonna close this, and now this building glass materials is applied on this building mesh. I'm gonna create a material instance by just right-clicking, and just you can create it. Now we got this building glass instance. Now we can apply it by dragging it. It's just the same your original. So if we just double-click it and open this up, we can see the parameter groups, and we can see the scala parameters we created. We can just enable this by checking this checkbox. You can now have the control of everything. Now you can change the colors, and of course there's the normal strength. Keep this pretty low value. So that was a simple way to control the building lights and create this kind of building materials. I guess it's kind of best solution to create this kind of buildings. You can see it's kind of low poly model. So this is actually simple box. It only has 8 triangles. And since this is a tiling textures, I mean seamless texture, you can just apply this material into any object. It's gonna work on any object. It's just, I guess it's too much. You can just copy this out and reduce the repeat UVs, and that's kind of simple thing. And now we got a color control. You can maybe set this to a random value. You can make some city scenes really quickly like this. And that was it actually. And if you like this video, please leave a comment, and thanks for watching.